Okay, hi. We are working in Animate today. I'm going to be showing you how to bring in Photoshop files into Animate. We'll be importing them onto the Animate stage. I'm going to be talking about symbols, how to set up the file in Animate, which is already set up for you as a template. We'll be creating art by carving out the image with the arrow tools. I'll be showing you the pen tool and the pencil tool, showing you how to do saving the file, creating a symbol, and making sure that your file is in the image that it needs to be. So here we go. We're going to start in Photoshop. For the identity deck playing cards, I have done 3 sketches. This was my first one, second one, and third one. I'm going to bring them all in as one file. I could bring them in separately, but I'm going to show you guys how to bring everything into one. So I want to bring them all into my most current one. I'm going to take this layer and drag it to that. Command T, hold down Shift and Option. That will go from the center and just make sure that it kind of is in the range of the size. Hit Return, that will say yes to that. Go back to this one. This is also just one layer. Going to take this layer and drag it onto this file. Command T, hold down Shift and Option. I'm just holding Shift at this point, pushing that in that direction. I'm going to hit F for full screen. Actually, I can't at this point, so I'm going to hit Return to say yes. F for full screen. That will put us into the full screen mode. Command minus to go down a bit. Now Command T, hold down Shift and Option, dragging with the Shift tool. Shift and Option. This is constraining the proportions so that it's as it needs to be. And it looks like to me this one is not proportionally correct, so I'm just going to drag that down to match the proportions of the previous cards because this was a photograph, not a scan. Then I'll hit Return. These layers are now all on here correctly. I've got that layer, this layer, this layer. Like I've said to you before, I want you guys to name your layers. I'm going to trash this one. It's not neat anymore with initial sketch. And this is our template. So I'm going to name this template. Name this Inuit card a ridge. Inuit dash A. And so I'm double clicking on those to rename Inuit dash B. All right, this file is now set up. I have a layer that is fully white. That will be fine. I can get rid of it in Animate if I need to. I do want to have my most recent image up on the top. So we'll do it that way. And you can see that that's correct now. Okay, so now I'm going to save this file. This file is, I'm going to hit F for full screen so I can see the name of the file that I'm working with. Susan Bonner, Inuit card -B. I want you guys to use your full name and then the title of the cards. All right, now we're ready to go into Animate. This file that is on the Google Drive for you is able to be downloaded. Make sure that when you do have it, if you had downloaded it before, that it's not black and red, but we're using now the magenta and the navy for the cards. Okay, I'm just going to give you an introduction to this particular file set and the way that I've set it up. On the top, you can see that I have a labels layer. There's for hearts, diamonds, spades, clubs, and the back. So basically, you can scrub through to get through all the hearts. You can see if you're going to be doing the jack of hearts, this will be the location that you'll be putting your art. Diamonds, etc. So the back does not have the same kind of template. So the template with the index holder is not on the back. So those of you that are working on the backs have access to the entire card set. All right, so first things first, I have to know where I'm going to be placing my piece. I am going to be doing one of these for fakes. You guys are actually doing these for real, so I will just pick a letter. I'll do the Jack of Hearts. So I go to that location where the Jack of Hearts is, and this is the layer that says art goes here. This is where I'm going to want to bring the file into. So I'm going to file, import to library. I have a folder that I've been importing from. It's the playing cards. This is probably where my file is. And just checking to see which file I'm going to get from. It's this one. This Photoshop file will come in with all of its layers, so I'm going to hit open. Now I want to take a look at my library. The import dialog box showed up here. The template, I do want to see this to make sure that we are in line, but and that might need some transformation for all of these. I'm just going to turn off layer 2 because I don't want to bring those in. Check out all these. Convert to animate layers, that's what we're going to want. We wouldn't want it to come in as keyframes because that will be along the timeline. We want to have them come in as animate layers. If we were just working with a single animate layer, that would make sense, but not for today with this particular file. We want the image to sure come in as a bitmap flattened image. I'm not going to create a movie clip. I'm also going to choose lossless for the compression. And here we go. I'm going to hit import. The next thing that has come up in terms of error messages, that Continuo is a font that is not being mapped correctly. It's actually one that we're not using, so I'm going to just say okay for that. It really won't be an issue. I'll get into the font uses in a little bit. Okay, so next I want us to all be using the same workspace. So I'm going to go up to Window and into Workspace right down here, and I will pull up the I do want to use the Animator workspace, but this is a little bit off because I've been using multi-monitors, so I'm going to go to Classic and then switch out back to the Animator one. So Window, Workspace, Animator. Okay, so this should be similar to what you guys have. This is the only difference, that my library is not in the correct spot. So I'm going to just bring this library over on top of my CC libraries. All right, so the PSD file is in here, and these are the layers that were brought in. It's not on the stage yet. I do recognize that I am in the Jack of Hearts, and so the next set is to create as many layers as these drawings are. So I'm going to create 4 layers. So, new layer. That's 4. I'm going to then shift-click through these and drag these onto the stage. Before I do that, however, I need to create a keyframe for this. So, F6 is the shortcut, or I'm going to do this on the next one. You can control-click and insert the keyframe. For those of you guys with the PCs, you will have to hold down your pen and then you will get access to this. So you kind of hold it down for about a second and then you can insert a keyframe. So that's what we need to do on all of these that I'm going to be bringing these drawings into. So Animate-A, bringing that to the stage. I'm going to zoom out, hitting Z, then clicking, holding down Option. You can see that it's not fitting. So in Photoshop, it's Command-T, but in Animate, it's Q for the Transform tool, which is up here. I'm going to hold down Shift and put it into the template as best as I can. Command-Z, you can see that I was actually using the other template, so Command-Z a couple of times. and lock all of the other layers and bring that in. Now I'll need to zoom in. So Q, hold down shift. You don't want to have the image be altered, so this is where just trying to get this to fit into the proportions of the given set. Okay, so that's set. And I would be doing that with all of these layers. The one that I really want is Inuit-B, so I'm going to bring that one in next. This, however, should be named Inuit-A. Actually, that was Inuit-Bridge. And then this one, I'm going to call it Inuit-B. Cool. So I'm going to bring this. Well, it's locked. I need to go to here, unlock it. This already has the keyframe on it. And I'm going to drag the Inuit-B there. Zoom out. Hit Z. Hold down the option. Hit Q. Transform holding the shift key. It's popped into place because of snapping. Okay, so this is where I'm wanting to view it at this point and start to work with our drawing method. For this one, I do want to make sure that the proportions are truly set. So I'm going to set it up to match that. I can not hold down shift if it needs to match more correctly. So you guys are just kind of making it fit into the given template on the Animate file. I'm going to turn off any images that I don't want to see at this point. I'm going to work with the Inuit-B file. So this is the sketch. I'm going to name it that. And now I'm going to make a new layer up above with a new keyframe here. So F6 on mine, or you're going to hold down your pad and insert a keyframe, or control click insert keyframe. Okay, so the next stage, we're going to take this drawing that was done traditionally and photographed, and we're going to use the technique of carving out the image. So I'm going to name this layer Carved Drawing. And right here is where I'm going to make some determinations. First, I want to point out that the file that you have received has two colors in the swatches that are specific to our needs. The magenta is right here, and the navy, which is further down, is right here. I'm going to do all of my drawing with the navy instead of black. Okay, so I'm going to go to that location. I'm going to zoom in on the face. And the idea with this is to make it so that you have a square, and then we're going to use the arrow tools to push and pull. The color that I have right now is navy on the inside and navy on the outside line. I want the inside to match the Pantone that I was given. So this is the Pantone that I'm working with. Okay, so now I'm ready to start my carving method. Okay, so the first thing to do is just to determine the square. You can see that my outline is much too large, so I'm gonna go into property, and that's coming from the stroke. So with it selected, I'm gonna double click. We are going to be using a stroke of 1. So you can just highlight that and hit 1, and then hit return, and then it will change your dimensions there. Now, I've talked with you guys about this before, that our line is very thin that we're using. You can see that it's thick when you select it, but it is a very thin line, especially compared to my drawing. That will be helpful as we continue. The other thing that I want to do is to make this transparent so I can start to see between the drawing and what I'm making. So I'm going to go into color. I'm going to take the alpha down to about 50%. It will adjust this so I can start to see under it. All right, so now I'm starting to get where I want. I do want to add that to the swatches. So I've clicked that. Now I've got a swatch that has a transparent because you can see the grid on it. All right, so the next thing to do is to start to shape out this face. With the arrow tool, the black arrow tool, which the shortcut is V, I can take and alter the shape of his face. I'm going to hit the A tool right now to get to this point, to get to his chin. Now I'm going to get the V tool to get to that. And you will just kind of keep shaping these elements until you have your more dynamic person. And we'll be able to alter these later as well, but I already have now the shape of his head. And I will just keep doing that using squares and circles. So here's another square, but then I'm going to hit V and pull this up, and pull this up, and pull this direction. And I'll just keep carving these out in such a way that it makes sense. So this again is a square for his glasses. V tool to pull this stuff around. This ear, I can use a circle. But then again, break that out into a V, or into the shape using the V tool. I'm going to delete that shape. I can do that because it's separated. They're connected. That's another circle for his ear. I don't like where that went, so I'll go to here. Delete that and Command Z a couple times because really what I would like to do on this particular one is to use the pen tool. So the now I can use the A tool to select that and delete it. And now I can use the B tool to move this stuff around. I'm just pushing and pulling this stuff until it starts to match the shapes that are predetermined. This doesn't have the color dumped into it, so I'm going to hit K as a shortcut for my new swatch that I've been using, which is here. It's not wanting to dump there, and I'll show you why. That is because there's this gap size is looking for it to not close, so I'm going to click Close Large Gaps. And still not wanting to do that, so I'll take a look closer, and I'll need to make sure that these bisect that. So now we'll hit K and we should be able to dump without a problem. Take this and delete that little section. Take this and delete that little section. Zoom out. All right, so this is the process. You're going to kind of keep going through this method and carve out your imaging.